Hello,
I'm Jeff Shuren, Director of the Center for Devices and Radiological Health at the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. We regulate devices, helping to get high-quality, safe and effective devices to patients every day. To help ensure patients with rare diseases have access to needed medical devices, the FDA established the Humanitarian Use Device Program. It offers a streamlined pathway for getting devices to market. The program began in 1990. And since then, FDA has approved 72 devices for rare diseases. Here, our center experts describe three of them.
Children need medical devices developed for their unique needs. As documented by our recent needs assessment, this is especially true for those with rare diseases. In 2017, FDA approved a device for a rare birth defect known as esophageal atresia. This is where the upper esophagus is disconnected from the lower esophagus and stomach. Babies with this condition cannot eat by mouth and may have breathing problems. Prior to this device approval, major thoracic surgery was the primary treatment option to repair this defect. Now, with this device, doctors can insert magnets into an infant's esophagus. Over several days, these magnets can stretch both ends of the esophagus and close the gap while surrounding tissue grows together.
Myelodysplastic and myeloproliferative neoplasms are rare cancers of the blood and bone marrow, in which the marrow makes either too few or too many blood cells. Certain changes to the patterns of genes in the DNA of the blood or bone marrow may be present in patients with these cancers. Diagnostic tests are powerful tools for measuring these changes, called biomarkers. In 2015, FDA approved a diagnostic test to detect a specific type of biomarker found in the bone marrow of these patients to help determine if they are a candidate for a specific cancer treatment.
An aneurysm is a weakening in an artery wall that results in a balloon-like bulge. Rarely, bifurcation aneurysms can occur where a major blood vessel divides into two. These occurrences cause the aneurysm to have a wider neck. A ruptured aneurysm can cause permanent damage or death, so doctors work to close it with a coil to reduce rupture risk. When an aneurysm has a wide neck, doctors must use a support device to help hold the coil in place without blocking the artery. In 2016, FDA approved a stent, a small cage-like device that provides the needed support to hold the coil in place.
These examples are just a snapshot of our commitment to spurring the development of innovative technologies for patients with rare diseases. We will continue this important work to give U.S. patients timely access to advanced medical devices.